first of all, I would like to say as well just how sorry I am and how sorry we are to particularly the victims of illegal voicemail interceptions and to their families. It's a matter of great regret of mine, my father's, and everyone at News Corporation. And these are standards, these actions do not live up to the standards that our company aspires to everywhere around the world. And it is our determination to both put things right, make sure these things don't happen again, and to be the company that I know we have always aspired to be. As for my comments, Mr. Chairman, and my statement, which I believe was around the closure of the News of the World newspaper.
Before you get to that, I would just like to say one sentence.
This is the most humble day of my life.
Okay, thank you. And the departure from your company in the recent few days of Tom Crone, of Rebecca Brooks, and of Les Hinton, is that because any of them had knowledge of phone hacking?
I have no knowledge, and there is no evidence that I'm aware of that Mrs. Brooks or Mr. Hinton or any of those executives had knowledge of that. And their assertions, certainly Mrs. Brooks and assertions to me of her knowledge of those things has been clear. Nonetheless, those resignations have been accepted, but it's important, you know, on the basis that there is no evidence today that I have seen or that I have any knowledge of that there was any impropriety.
Can I take you back to 2003? Are you aware that in March of that year, Rebecca Brooks gave evidence to this committee admitting paying police?
I am now aware of that. I was not aware at the time. I'm also aware that she amended that for considerably, very quickly afterwards.
I think she amended it 7 or 8 years afterwards. But did you or anyone else?
Sorry.
Did you or anyone else at your organisation investigate this at the time?
No.
Can you explain why?
I didn't know of it. I'm sorry. If I can just say something. And this is not as an excuse, maybe as an explanation of my laxity. The News of the World is less than 1% of our company. I employ 53,000 people around the world who are proud and great and ethical and distinguished people, professionals in their life. And perhaps I'm spread watching and appointing people whom I trust to run those divisions.
Why did you not dismiss News of the World chief reporter Neville Thirlbeck following the Mosley case?
I'd never heard of him.
Okay. Despite a judge making clear that Thirlbeck set out to blame two of the women involved.
I didn't hear that.
A judge made it clear that Thirlbeck set out to blackmail two of the women involved in the case.
That is the first I've heard of that.
So none of your UK staff draw your attention to this serious wrongdoing, even though the case received widespread media attention?
I think my son can perhaps answer that in more detail. He was a lot closer to it.
I'll come to your son in a minute. So despite the fact that blackmail can result in a 14-year prison sentence, nobody in your UK company brought this fact to your attention?
The blackmail charge, no.
Mr. Murdoch, at what point did you find out that criminality was endemic at News of the World?
Endemic is a very hard, it's a very wide-ranging word. And I also had to be extremely careful not to prejudice the course of justice which is taking place now. That has been disclosed. I became aware as it became apparent, the first two, and then I was absolutely shocked, appalled, and ashamed when I heard about the Millie Dowler case only 2 weeks ago, eight days before I saw them. It was graciously received by the Dowlers.
Mr. Murdoch, Why did you decide to risk the jobs of 200 people before pointing the finger at those responsible for running the company at the time of the illegality? Your son and Rebecca
Brooks. When a company closes down, it is natural for people to lose their jobs. We have, in this case, and are making, is continuing, every effort to see that those people are employed in other divisions of the company if they're not part of the small group, or I don't know how big the group, whatever group was involved in criminality.
Did you close it because of the criminality?
Hmm?
Did you close the paper down because of the criminality?
Yes, we felt ashamed of what had happened and thought we were going to bring it to a close.
People lied to you and lied to their readers.
We had broken our trust with our readers. Certainly broken with me. But it was, the important point was we had broken our trust with our readers. I was invited within days to have a cup of tea to be thanked for the support by Mr. Cameron. No other conversation took place.
And that's
lasted minutes.
And that's the one you went in through the back door?
Yes. I had been asked also by Mr. Brown many times.
Through the back door?
Yes.
Mr. Murdoch, do you accept that ultimately you are responsible for this whole fiasco?
No.
You're not responsible. Who is responsible?
The people that I trusted to run it, and then maybe the people they trusted.
Can you name
I worked with Mr. Hinton for 52 years and I would trust him with my life.
Are you familiar with the term willful blindness?
Mr. Sanders, would you care to elaborate?
It is a term that came up in the Enron scandal. And willful blindness is a legal term. It states that if there is knowledge that you could have had and should have had, but chose not to have, you are still responsible.
Mr. Sanders, do you have a question? Respectfully, I don't know what you'd like me to say.
Whether you were aware...
I'm not aware of that. I'm not aware of that particular phrase.
But now you are familiar with the term because I've explained it to you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Sanders.
I've heard the phrase before, and we were not ever guilty of that.
Thank you.
Were any payments made subsequently to Clive Goodman and Glenn Mulcair after their conviction? Did News International make any payments at all to those two people following their convictions?
Yeah. I'd like to answer that question. I think it's a good question, and it's a specific question. To my knowledge, upon asking, because there were allegations made that legal fees had been paid after that time in 2007 to those. I asked the question myself, and I was very surprised to find that the company had made certain contributions to legal settlements. I don't have all of the details around each of those, not legal settlements, sorry, legal fees around there. And I just, and I was surprised. I was very surprised to find
out
that that had occurred.
Who authorized
them? They were done, as I understand it, in accordance with legal counsel. Say and the strong advice to.
No, I didn't say who advised it. Who signed it off? Who at News International agreed to make the? Who signed the checks? Who agreed to make those payments?
I do not know who signed off those.
I mean,
we're
talking about corporate governance earlier. You talked about the managing editor. Would the managing editor have made that decision?
It would have been the management. It would have been the management of the legal cases, I would think. But I think we have to. I'm happy to go back and look at that, but it was not something that came to my attention for approval.
But who would make that
decision? I'd like to say, figures of that amount would certainly not come before or having to do with the managing editors.
It wouldn't. Would it have been above the managing editor or below the managing editor?
It'd be above.
Well, above.
This would have been the legal. This would have been on legal advice, payments made about how to handle litigations. I don't have direct knowledge or details around the current status of those. But I can tell you, I was as surprised as you are to find that some of those arrangements had been made.
Were either Rebecca Brooks or Lessington, were they asked to leave, or did they ask to leave?
They both asked to leave.
Why did you not accept Rebecca Brooks's resignation when she first offered it?
Because I believed her, and I trusted her, and I do trust her.
And so why did you accept it the second time round? Why did you accept
it? In the event, she just insisted. She was... at a point of
And can you
tell us
Can you tell us how much all of these characters have been paid off? How much they've been given in as a financial settlement on their departure from News International?
No, I can't tell you, but in the case of Mr. Hinton, it would certainly be considerable because it would be pensions for 52 years service, a great deal of things.
And would it be 10 million? 5 million? 10 million?
Those
are confidential.
I don't know.
Those are
certainly confidential.
The sitting is suspended for 10 minutes.
Can I, at this stage, say that both of you have been very cooperative to this committee, and we have appreciated that. You have answered questions for a long time, and I would like to apologise on behalf of the committee and Parliament for the way you have been treated, and I will make a report to the Speaker, and I assure you we will take action to try and find out how that was able to occur.
I think that it's important that we don't say, listen, everybody was doing it, and that's why people are doing this. At the end of the day, we have to have a set of standards that we believe in. We have to have titles and journalists who operate to the highest possible standard. And we have to make sure that when they don't live up to that, that they are held to account. And that's really the focus for us.
You said that your friend of 52 years, I think, Les Hinton, had stepped down and had resigned because he was in charge of the company at the time. In other words, he said he was the captain of the ship and therefore he resigned. Is it not the case, sir, though, that you, in fact, are the captain of the ship? You are the chief executive officer of News Corp, the global corporation.
It's a much bigger ship, but yes.
It is a much bigger ship, but you are in charge of it. And as you said in earlier questions, you do not regard yourself as a hands-off chief executive. You work 10 to 12 hours a day. This terrible thing happened on your watch. Mr. Murdoch, have you considered resigning?
No.
Why not?
Because I feel that people I trusted, I'm not saying who, I don't know what level, but let me down, and I think they behaved disgracefully and betrayed the company and me, and it's for them to pay. I think that, frankly, I'm the best person to clean this up.
Mr. Murdoch, your wife is a very good left hook.
Thank you.
Yeah.